time, bruh.
All right, well, you know, to explain to everyone, who are you guys?
Okay.
そうですね、僕はもう、20年以上ずっと鉄拳プロジェクトで、携わって、プロジェクトのリーダーやってます。まあ、鉄拳以外にも、ソウルキャリバーに携わったり、あとポッケンだとか、最近だと VR の、サマーレッスンとか、そういうものもいろいろやっています。
So obviously this is Katsuhiro Harada. He's been in the Tekken series for over 20 years, but also worked on other projects like Soul Calibur, also Pokken, and Summer Lesson. Michael Murray, I've done game design on the Tekken series, but also many years ago also did localization on the franchises you mentioned like Soul Calibur, Ace Combat, Rage, those kind of things.
Well, it's awesome to know. Well, how are you guys liking Australia so far?
やっぱり気候がすごく良くて、いいのと、まあ、5年ぶりぐらいなんですけど、もともと非常に鉄拳ファンも多い土地なので、まあ、居心地はいいですよね。
The climate is actually quite nice here during our stay. It's probably the first time in maybe 5 years we've been. The last time was for Tag 2. And also there's a lot of Tekken fans here, so it's very comfortable for us.
Well, we'll get right into it. So, through my preview, I noticed that Tekken 7 appears to have the most direct narrative or story that any Tekken has had. What prompted you guys to have such a direct story mode?
You mean the way the story is portrayed, or
yeah.
Because of the person who's kind of narrating the machine mode?
Yeah, yeah, so like just the approach and
okay.
You know, the actual design of it.
Well, this time, it was quite different.なんでこういう描写にしたのかって多分、まあ、ストーリーを見せる方法もそうだし多分言ってるのは記者の目線から言ってるのもそう
だ。 あれ見たのかな、もうそうですね。
So you play the story mode?
Yes.
まあそうですね、できるだけ今回のストーリーモードの、まあ、重要なポイントは内容ももちろんそうなんですけど、これまでの鉄拳ファンと、あと逆にセブンだけ買う、もしくはセブンから入る人、これ両方が同じ体験をしなきゃいけないんです。で、その時に実はカズヤとヘハチはなぜ戦うことになり、どうしてカズミが死んだのかとか、その歴史って実は従来のファンも知らないし、新しく来る人にとっても、まあ、平等にどちらも知らないことなんですね。で、それを語るにおいて、非常に第三者的な分析とか冷静な目線があれば、誰にとっても、まあ、非常に、興味深く、しかも納得のしやすい表現になるだろうということで、あえてちょっと今回、主観同士、格闘を買って自分の主観のぶつかり合いだと思うんですけど、ちょっと客観的に見る人間っていうのをあえて入れるっていう手法を選ぶことで、みんなに分かりやすくしたってとこ大きいですね。
Well, this time for the story mode, we kind of envision long-time fans of the series, but also people who are maybe new to Tekken series, both are going to be experiencing the same story mode. So, there are a lot of mysteries that long-time fans don't know, like why are father and son, Heihachi and Kazuya, fighting each other? How and why did Heihachi's wife, Kazumi, die? There's a lot of mysteries that are kind of going to be portrayed through the story mode this time. So,to actually portray this to newcomers and veteran fans of the series, we thought that kind of rather than a perspective from the fighter, you know, one of the characters, that it would be kind of more in depth and easier to follow if it were done from a third person perspective of the generals that you saw.
Well, it definitely showed. I mean, very accessible, so I can imagine that newcomers will have an easy time following the story. But has it been difficult at all?You know, approaching it this way, making sure that it's accessible for both long-time fans and newcomers.
難しかったから、うん、その、まあ、どっちも
満足させる、
そうです
ね。まあ、従来のファンにとってはもう、話は非常にディープなところまで追求しているので、まあ、多分非常に興味を持ってもらえるだろうってとこと、まあ、ゲームプレイはやっぱりね、従来のファンは 自分のコントロールで楽しめるんで全く問題ないだろうと思ってて、むしろ今回からやっぱり入ってくる人向けにそのストーリーアシストっていうシステムを導入したりっていう工夫の方がやっぱりしっかりスタッフが考えてくれたんで、だいぶあれは今回だけの成功、今回だけでできてることじゃなくて、実はあの 3DS の時にやってたからこそああいう発想が入ってきたっていうことを思うと、やっぱりこう今回だけじゃなくて長年こう世代交代が早いこの鉄拳っていうシリーズに対して新しく入ってきた人のことを常に考えてたっていうのがようやくいいアイデアになってる形で出てきたんで、それはすごい良かったなと思ってます。
Well, it wasn't that difficult because, you know, first off, we think of the long-time fans when we're trying to cover these storylines that have been left hanging and to try to tie them up in some manner. And long-time fans of the series have no trouble in using the control of their choice to kind of proceed through the story mode. But what we paid particular attention to was the newcomers and how to get them to be able to progress through the storyline.And one of the ways that this was done was the kind of option you have in the controls to like a, I don't know, it's called, 何て呼んでたんだっけ日本語、なんとかアシスト。
ストーリーアシスト。
I think it's called story assist. What it is, you know, if you have like a uppercut motion to do one of the wind god fists, for example, it might be kind of difficult for newcomers, right? So in the story mode, they have this special assist feature thatyou can do a combination of, for example, one of the shoulder buttons and, for example, square to do, easily do some of these techniques. And you can, there's different ones assigned, so you can kind of put them together for combos and such. So that's like what we're calling the story assist. So the newcomers are able to more easily control the characters in story mode and to help them kind of progress through that. And this wasn't done just right off the bat from Tekken 7, butIt's kind of based on the experience we gained from Tekken on 3DS, in which they had a similar type of system with being able to perform the techniques by touching different panels and such. So that's kind of extension, this time what we're doing with that, to kind of make the game more accessible for both novice and experienced players.
Well, it shows. I mean, I'm not the most professional Tekken player there is, butit was cool to be able to use those flashier moves that are hard hitting without having to memorize all the commands.
So you actually tried it out?
Yeah, it was quite a useful feature.
That's cool.
So obviously, this is one of the first Tekken games to be released on PC.
Right.
So obviously, a lot of PC gamers will be happy to have this, and it's, you know, the best-selling fighter franchise.
Right.
And so I was wondering, will the frame rate be locked for PC users?
PC で
初めて、ねうん、いやまあ基本的には鉄拳は60フレームで、しっかり動くっていうのがコンソールも PC もそれがやっぱポリシーとしてやってるので、フレームレートは60ですね。ただ PC の場合はもう NVIDIA のページとかにも載って YouTube にも上がってますけど 4K の素材とかがこうまあ、PC のスペックさえ良ければ 4K で楽しめるようになっているので解像度とか非常に高くなりますね。
Well, Tekken, you know, needs 60 frames to be locked down for the game system. So, obviously, if you have a PC within the minimum to recommended specs, the game will be running 60 frames. And if you have very nice hardware that's even higher than that, then what you can do is to be able to perhaps play in 4K or a higher resolution.And you can see just how good the game looks in those resolutions with some videos that have been uploaded, I think by NVIDIA and on our channels as well.
Yeah, well, actually, I've got to play a bit of the PC build. It's a bit of an older build, but it looked fantastic nonetheless.
Thank you.
Well, speaking of other platforms, is there any possibility of Tekken 7 coming to the Switch?
まあちょっとね会社的には基本的ノーコメントで、そもそもちょっと我々まだ忙しくてちょうどスイッチ出てる時期ってそのちょっと我々自身もまだ手に入れてないので、もう少しスイッチのこと勉強したいなっていうふうに思いますね。
Well, it's kind of hard to comment on officially, as our company policy is not to really discuss what our plans are with Switch yet. I mean, not just for Tekken, but in general.
Fair enough.
That said, you know, I mean, it looks like interesting hardware, and but we've just been so busy with the development on the three platforms we've announced that we don't have any plans at the moment. Neither of us either have a Switch, so I guess we need to get our hands on the hardware and to check it out first.
Yeah, makes sense. It would be awesome to be able to play Tekken 7 on the go.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, on the way here, I was just playing Zelda on the train.
Oh, wow. The game is supposed to be amazing.
It's pretty good. Well, seeing as we've got the PlayStation 4 Pro out already and Xbox Scorpio slated to release sometime towards the end of the year, will Tekken 7 utilize the extra hardware and specs that those platforms will have? So we'll be able to run 4K on the consoles or with HDR or anything?
PS4 Pro
は出てる。ああ、それに対して、あ、一応。
HDR とか、で、今度。
HDR あるな。そこそこ。全部一緒くたにしようとって話がややこしいんだ。あの情報も出していいんだっけ。基本的にエンハンスドってつくようになる、なるんだよね。おっしゃる。けど、まだ言ってないよね。
何も言ってないけど、基本的に何もしてないじゃん。要は、そのハード
が。まあ、そうだね。
まあ、ちょっと綺麗になるっていう感じ。
綺麗にはなるよね。
言えない。
まあ少なくとも PS プロをでやると、あ、綺麗だなっていうふうにはなるんで、まあ、あの
開発技術で動いてるみたいな、
うん、
確か綺麗な。
持ってる人は PS4 プロで遊んだ方が多分全然良くて、スコーピオとかについてはまだまだその、うん、発表されたばっかりで我々のから言えることは今のところ何もないですね。
So PS4 Pro, I mean, I can't really go into much detail about it, but we've seen it running on a dev kit for the Pro, and you can see that it's going to look better than the normal standard PS4 version. So I would say it's definitely better to play on a PS4 Pro if you have one. As far as Scorpio, it's, you know, there's a lot of stuff that is unknown about the hardware at the moment. It's kind of early. So there's not really any plans that we have at the moment.
Fair enough. Well, we'll move on to some of the versus mode stuff.
Okay.
Has balancing been an issue at all? Because in previous games you've had certain characters like Gon in Tekken 3 who were a little more overpowered than others.
The balance の問題あったのかとか。まあでもゲームを出して、
そうだね。もともとね、やってるもんね。
強かったのはまあ今。許容範囲内に、あ、そもそも。
そうですね。だからその鉄拳シリーズのいいところは、最初にやっぱりアーケードって非常にシビアな、市場でリリースしていること。だから多くの格闘ゲーム、まあ格闘ゲームに限らず多くのゲームは今ベータテストっていうのは必要としてると思うんですけど、鉄拳の場合はある意味そのワンプレイ100円って非常につまんなかったらもうやめられる、バランスが悪かったらみんながやめちゃうような世界で、アップデート重ねてポリッシュ、非常にゲーム自体ポリッシュされているので、まあ、チューニングも変化はしてきた、来て最新の状態がやっぱ家庭用に反映されるので、もちろん今後もサポート、チューニングサポートはしていくつもりですけど、いわゆるかなり完成度が高い状態で、バランスという意味ですね、ゲームは完成してますけど、バランスがいい状態で、家庭は発売されるとみんな思ってもらっていいと思いますね。
クロス
は点
としては多
分ゴーキーだよね。まあゴーキーはやっぱり 2D 格闘のシステムそのまま持ってきちゃってるんで、なかなかゲームバランスは苦労はしました。ただ今、非常にいいレベルに落ち着いていると思います。
So it was a little bit difficult. You mentioned Gon, but I guess this time the character that stands out the most as being non-Tekken would be Akuma.And so, obviously, since the way he's played is more, the way he plays in 2D fighting games, and quite different than Tekken, we did have to put a lot of effort into that. But since the game, you know, other fighting games that are just console only, have to have some kind of beta tests or revisions and such. But with Tekken, we still have a very healthy arcade scene. So we were able to release in arcades and have him fine-tuned before the game comes out later in June on console. So obviously all the character balancing is pretty optimal at this point.
Alright, that's good to know. Well, obviously for a while it's been confirmed that Tekken 7 will support a VR mode for the PlayStation VR. Is that something that will ship with launch, or will VR players have to wait a bit?
ああ
基本的に入る、
うん、
基本的に発売日と同時っていうのはもう決まってるんで、基本的には発売した時には遊べるようになってると思います。はい、
yeah, it's safe to say that the people will be able to play it on launch.
It's good to know. A lot of my friends who are PSVR were waiting to hear that because there hasn't been too much learned about it other than it will support it. Well, what should PSVR users expect in terms of the experience?
まあ、
遊んだ？
うん、もちろん、もちろん。
あれすごいよね。うん、割れるようにするんだけど、うん、俺があの CPU と対戦してスローにして、
うん、そう、スローにできるんだね。
すごい。
あれ面白いよね。
面白
かったよ。だから、今回ゲームの中にスーパースローシステムって入れてるんですけど、それを任意に発動できるので、非常に動き、キャラクターの動きとかコスチュームとか、スーパースロー状態にしたり、まあ、通常の速度で見たりとかって形でちょっと、自分で動かしながら見れるので、まあ、モデルビューアーモードとその CPU との対戦をじっくり見るみたいなちょっと面白い使い方はできるので、そこは一回とにかく見てもらえば面白いと思ってもらえると思う。
珍しいよね、鉄拳とあんまりいろんな角度から見れ
る。そうそう、見れないので、うん、なるほどこうなってるんだっていうのはすごく VR でしか見れないところですね。
It's quite interesting because you've probably seen the super slow motion of the game when two people trade blows and slow themselves down, but in the PSVR you have this kind of mode where you can look at the character model andyou know, customize it and look at different angles and such. But there's also a method where you can play against the CPU and slow down the battle, like super slow, but you know, whenever you like. And you can kind of see the techniques and animations from different angles and distances. And that's something you can't normally see in Tekken. So it is kind of unique and pretty cool.
Obviously, since you're using Unreal Engine 4, it's a very graphically intensive engine. Was it difficult having to decide what concessions to make sure that the VR part of Tekken 7 ran at a full 60 frames?
Unreal で、
VR で
65画素どれぐらい難しいか。
まあ多分
この
両方120だから。
なら
ま
あ。VR 対応自体を UE 方が結構やっぱサマーレスの時にもエピックゲームズをやってて結構早くからそこに取り組んでたっていうのはちょっとそういう意味でアンリアルエンジンに対する不安っていうのは早くから取り組んでたんであんまりなかったですね。ただどっちにしても格闘ゲームってもともと60フレームで動かすのにすごい大変なのに画面分割してまた60で保つっていうのは確かにハードル高かったのでできるだけステージとかをちょっと工夫して、60フレームしっかり安定できるようにはしてますね。
うん、yeah, I mean, there wasn't anything difficult related to the Unreal Engine because also with Summer Lesson and Tekken, we worked closely with them to try to get optimal performance with our games. But for Tekken, since it's a fighting game andhas to have 60 frames, not just on one screen, but you know, two of the way that VR works. We did have to put a lot of thought into the treatment of the stages that you play on and such to make sure that the game runs at a stable 60 frames.
I can imagine it's almost like rendering two things at once.
Pretty much,
it's,
yeah.
It's very process hungry.
Yeah.
Well, this year marks the 20th anniversary for Tekken 3, my favorite Tekken game.
Mm-hmm.
そうだっけ、鉄拳3の20周年、
うん、そうなんだよ、そうなんだよ、
う
ん、この間ファンが勝手に騒いでた。
It came out on March 20th, 1997. So, are there any plans to sort of commemorate this occasion in-game?
それなんかゲーム内に、
いや、まああまりその特定のナンバリングに対する何周年っていうのは我々あんまり意識してないので、うん、ただやっぱり鉄拳7には今までの鉄拳の、まあ、ストーリー的な要素もそうですけど 本当にいいとこ全部詰まってると思うんで、特にギャラリーモード見てもらえば、みんなが懐かしいと思ってたエンディング、オープニング、ありとあらゆる、もうあれ見てるだけでもすごい時間がかかりますね、多分すっごいボリュームなので、もうブルーレイに突っ込めるだけ突っ込んでるんで、ぜひそこはちょっと見てほしいですね。
We haven't really thought about the, you know, the 20th anniversary or any anniversaries of a particular installment in the series、but you know, Tekken 7 does kind of include a lot of the best elements of some of the past installments, butOne in particular is in the gallery mode. You can look at, you know, Indian movies and other artwork and such for throughout the series, and you can imagine the amount of volume to that. And it is kind of cool to go back and kind of revisit the different character endings and the story, etc. We really put a lot of footage in it. I mean, we have limited capacity with the Blu-ray, you know, because you have to have the game itself. But even so, we put a whole lot of game footage from past installments. So.That's something that we hope everyone will check out.
Well, are there any plans for post-launch content support, whether it be through free updates or paid DLC?
7でしょ。そっかそっか。まあ今までの鉄拳はですね、発売してからタイムリリースキャラって形で、まあ2ヶ月ないし3ヶ月キャラを出して、もう以上サポート全て終了だったんで、チューニングとかもできなかったんですけど、今回初めてシーズンパスっていう形で DLC を、有料の形にしてます。でこれによって、そのバジェットを確保、チームを鉄拳プロジェクトっていうのを継続できる、バジェットを確保できたので、少なくともやっぱり発売してから、1年間は、やっぱり新しいコンテンツや、チューニングとか、の含めたサポートっていうのをやっていこうと思ってます。
So up until now you probably know Tekken has、had a little bit of DLC, but it's been pretty limited because it was for free and、without a budget it's kind of hard to maintaina large team like Tekken to stay behind the game. So for Tekken 7, we decided to do paid DLC this time. And in the past, you know, we had to kind of, you know how Tekken has time release characters in arcade, etc. We tried to recreate something similar with Tag 2 where we released characters after launch, but that only lasted for about 3 months. We weren't able to do a lot of tuning like we normally would. So this time,because of the paid DLC that allows us to continue to support the game for at least a year after launch with new content and also balance updates and such.
You know, it's good to hear the game will receive post-launch content and support. You know, it's an issue with some of these games where, you know, the launch is it.
Right.
Well,
we've already announced a season pass, so it includes two characters and some other game content.I think it's the only content we touched on at the moment.
Well, this is more a question for my friend Nick, because he's a big fan of the character. Will Lee, the police officer, be returning?
Udon? みんな、なんだろうな。そう、いる時にもっと騒いでほしいんだよね。ちゃんと彼らがいる時に、我々はあのキャラが好きだ、面白いって騒いでほしいし、実際使ってほしいんだけど、みんなまあエディとかもね、発表される前まではなんでいないんだなんでいないんだって大騒ぎするんだけど、やっぱりそうなってからではなくて、そうなる前からサポートしてくれないと、こう登場しないキャラは当然やっぱりシリーズ長いとキャラも増えるんで、何人か出てきちゃうんですけど、やっぱり、普段のサポートもっと欲しいですね。そしたらもうちょっといろいろ出す順番とか変わってくるんじゃないかなと思うんですけ
ど。It's difficult, you know, because we have people that give feedback like, oh, we want Lei Wulong or whoever it is at that time. But it's kind of tough for us because.When he's in the game, like in Tag 2, you don't really see a lot of people using the character that's being talked about like that. And if people really like the character, they should be more vocal and they should use the character more often. until waiting until he's not announced for Tekken 7, and then, oh my god, he's not there. What are you going to do? Put him in?
Yep.
We wish that people would support their favorite characters, you know, from earlier on when they're already in the game, etc. So it's very difficult, the balance there, because we have new characters with each installment. So obviously, not every single character who's ever been in the game is going to make each installment. So it's kind of tough to balance. So if you really feel that strongly, we hope to, that everyone will support the characters from much earlier.
You hear that, people? Anyway, so I noticed during my playthroughs and during just the versus mode that the battle arenas and stages are quite varied compared to one another. What were the inspirations that caused you to have such a contrast in between stages?
今回すごいステージのバリエーションが豊富で、
うん、
まあ、どういう発想というかどういう方向を考えてたのか、
昔格闘ゲームで流行ったのって世界の何だろう観光巡りみたいな、
あピラミッドだったり
そう昔の格闘ゲーム全部そうで、鉄拳もちょっとそれに近いことやってたんですけど、鉄拳セブンは、やっぱ結構今回この親子の対決が非常にシリアスなもので、こう対決した時のいわゆる最終決戦クライマックスっていうのをイメージしてたので、大体どのステージも戦いにふさわしくこうクライマックスシーンにふさわしいもの。でまた加えてこうファイナルステージになると雨が降ってきたりとか風がすごい吹いてきたりとかって結構ステージによって変化が大きく起きる。っていうのも意識したので、まあ、そういうちょっと漫画とか映画とかの最終決戦の場所みたいなイメージで全体を構成します。
Fighting games, if you're familiar with them, a lot of the major titles in the past had kind of done these, familiar landmarks or tourist spots like your pyramids or whatever. So, you know, Tekken had also kind of followed that theme, throughout the series.This time, though, the main theme is probably, because of the storyline and the face-off between the two, the father and son, kind of a climax, I guess you could say. In almost any of the stages could be the setting for this climax. And you see the kind of evolution in the stages in between rounds where maybe rain, it starts to rain or the wind picks up or something like this to kind of, help draw that environment of, feeling like final showdown stage. So that was kind of the direction, for most of the stages, that any of them could be, the setting for that.
Well, I noticed compared to a lot of other fighters which do a more, take more, say, cartoony, direction with their art direction, Tekken 7 has a more realistic or mature approach to its art. Was this a conscious decision where you guys?
他のファイターはちょっとカートゥーンライクなテイストだけど、
うんね、
非常にシリアスで、
うん、
デザインされたステージだけど、その意図的な、まあ、方向性なのかと、
まあ、結構意図的ですよね、まあ、そのただホットリアルってわけではないので、ちょっとその日本でいうところの劇画的なイメージで作ってるのが意図を持ってやってますね。
きっとあれだよね、うん、もっと前の鉄拳って海のステージだったりいろんなもっとライトなやつだけど、今回ストーリー性すご
い、うん、だからちょっともちろん今回も面白いステージっていうのは、ね、うん、ちょっと増えて、ね、家庭向けに増やしてはいるものの、やっぱり、うん、全体のトーンとして劇画的なドラマチックっていうキーワードでやってるんで、
It's, We wouldn't say that the game is photorealistic. I mean it doesn'tstrive to be real per se. It's just the influence of Tekken, one of the strongest ones is a Japanese comic style called Gekiga, which is very like, dramatic flair to it. So I guess that's kind of the major design element in the stages. And it kind of reinforces the story as well. Is the main direction, though there are some kind of lighthearted fun stages still there.
Yeah, like the boxing ring.
is that the esports one you're talking about, like the arena? Or the Kinder one?
Can't remember exactly.
So there's quite a variety this time.
Yeah, it's good to see it helps break from the monotony that can be fighting games, just playing over and over again.
Right. And did you notice the change in between the rounds as well?
Yeah, some of them.
It's pretty cool this time.
It does help keep you in the atmosphere and through in racing, which is good to see. Well, has the launch and success of other fighting games helped at all with the development process of Tekken 7?
In what manner?
Street Fighter V, how that had a quite abysmal launch with its online structure.
Right.
Has there been much of a focus to make sure that it's running at 100% or somewhat on launch?
Street Fighter の launch とか、そういったものって影響してるのか、鉄拳の開発に。あいつらが失敗したから俺らもっとここに力入れるべきだとか、そういう。
あ、そういう影響の仕方じゃないですね。そんなのも見てから。何かするのはもう手遅れなんで、それは計画通りですね。どっちかというと、もともと発売とかに関しては、全部のメーカーではないですけど、少なくともカプコンさんと小野さんと僕が話をして、こうカニバラないように、紳士協定じゃないですけど、お互いに情報を出し合って、だいたいこれぐらいのロードマップで出そうと思うんだよねって話はお互い実はしてますね。そうなんだよね。だから他のメーカーともちょっともうちょっとうまくやんなきゃいけないんだね。
Well, not really. I mean, it hasn't affected the design of the game because that was at a point that when we saw the launch of Street Fighter, it was already, our plans were already solidified and we were already in development. So it's not like we had enough time to look at their launch and then react to it really. We basically just followed our original game plan through launch.Though we did consult with Onosan and Street Fighter or Capcom about launch timing, etc. early on so that we don't kind of conflict with each other. And I was just teasing him that he should have done that with Warner Brothers and ARK because they come out around the same time. So well, maybe in the future we'll become closer with him.
You never know. In previous iterations of the Tekken series, we've seen fun little mini games like Tekken Bowling and Tekken Ball. Will there be anything like that for players to play during your playthrough of Tekken 7?
まあ、そうですね。ストーリーモードで結構今回いろいろ凝ってるんで、まずはその我々のアイデアだとか今まで培ってきたそのムービーの技術のちょっとした遊びの部分も全部。結構ストーリーモードに集約してるんで、そこを注目してもらいたいなというのと、そうでなくても結構今回新しい試みのモード、オンライントーナメントモード含めて、さっき言ったギャラリーモード含めて、もうかなりのボリュームでいろいろ入っているので、まずそこを注目してもらいたいなという思いがあります。
So, I guess it's safe to say that a lot of those...type of gameplay elements that people liked in the previous installments in a separate mode are kind of more incorporated into the story mode this time. It's not just a one-on battle with the standard fighting conditions. There's a lot of these kind of ideas that we had to kind of change it up and to make it more like the modes you mentioned. So that's kind of been, I guess you could say, implemented into the story mode itself. And then there's also other new elements of the game, such as the online tournament andthese kind of new things that we're doing. So it's kind of similar but different at the same time, what we're trying to do.
So it's like creating variety in a familiar series.
Right.
Well, given that the game will be available on the three major platforms, have there been many development setbacks during the process?
Platform of its domo やってるので、ちょっと何かトラブったとか。
ああ、そういう意味？
要は発売日も変わったしな、その辺。
ああ、変わったというか、とは対外的にはね、別に変わってはいない。初めて発表した日があれだったんだけど。やっぱりその、
ね、
シングルプラットフォームよりかはやっぱマルチの方が苦労することは明らかに多いので、レギュレーションがっていうかその TCR、TRC と言われるものがやっぱ違ったりとか。求められるものもね、PC だけはハイスペックのものがあったりとか、 当然ながら多分エクスクルーシブプラットフォームである方が開発速度は明らかに速くなるでしょうねとは言えますね。
Well, it's difficult to say exact details about it, but I guess you could say that it is three platforms and they all have their own、technical requirements, etc. and also specs、that we have to cover. So、it's safe to say that it did take more time to create、the same level of content and、to match the different、platforms、requirements and such as well. And also PC, you know, there's other things that、PC players require.Depending on hardware, etc. So, if we were on just a single, you know, exclusive platform, I guess you could say that it wouldn't take as much time as it has this time.
Fair enough. Well, last question, a nice and easy one. Who are your favorite Tekken characters?
やっぱりそのキャラクターとしては平八ですかね。で、まあプレイヤブルというかプレイしている時は割と平明を選びがちですね。
He said he likes the Heihachi as a character, you know, story setting and everything included. But just playing the game is good for him to be Fenway. For me, Devil Jin, obviously, just because、I tried so hard to, you know, the Mishima is one of the more difficult、characters to get good at the game.
Yeah.
And、just his, the look of the character I fell in love with at the start.、and also Josie this time. She's one of the newer characters and I always pick up a new character with each installment. And some of the.You know, the kick attacks and the kickboxing-like elements to her, I really like. So it's quite a different character than Devil Jin.
Yeah, well, you know, for me, I can't go past Yoshimitsu.
Yoshimitsu, huh?
Yes, I love him. Anyway, so thank you for coming in and letting me interview you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoy the rest of your stay in Australia. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
But, you know, we'll leave it at that.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you for coming.